friends, and welcome back to another Pokemon how-to guide. My name is Lee, also known as Osiris, and in today's guide, we're going to be looking at how to obtain the very rare Pokemon Dreepy, Drakloak, and Dragapult, which are the new Ghost and Dragon types available in the Sword and Shield titles. Now, these Pokemon are very strong, but they are a little bit tricky to obtain if you don't know the right conditions with when to look for them. Hopefully, through this guide, I'll give you all the tips and tricks with how to obtain these Pokemon so you can go out there and utilize them in battle. So the first thing that we need to do is identify exactly where these Pokemon spawn. Now, if you open up your town map, you want to be looking at the upper part of the wild area, and it's in the top left-hand corner, and it is the Lake of Outrage. This is the area where Dreepy and Drakloak will spawn in the wild, but only under certain weather conditions. Now, the weather conditions in this area need to be either foggy, cloudy or overcast, or a thunderstorm. There is a 2% chance for both fog and thunderstorm for these Pokemon to spawn, and a 1% chance if it's cloudy or overcast. To optimize your chances of catching this Pokemon, you really want the weather to be foggy or a thunderstorm. Now, how to identify what the weather is in this specific area or other areas around the Galar region? What you need to do is open your town map, and then once that's open, if you press the plus button on your Joy-Con, it will toggle on the weather in that specific area, and that's how you're able to tell what the weather is. Unfortunately, as you can see for me right now, it is very sunny in this area. That means I will not be able to catch these Pokemon right now, so I need the weather to change. How long that will take, I don't know, but here's a little trick for you. What you can do to change the weather to be more suitable to catch these Pokemon is a little trick. So if you hit the home button on your Joy-Con, what you want to do is go back to the home screen and then go down to your system settings and then go right the way down in this list and go to system. Then you want to find the date and time. You want to toggle off synchronized clock via the internet and then go down to the date and time and change your date to tomorrow. Now come out of this, go back to the home screen, go back into the game, open your town map, and then toggle on the weather again, and you can see that the weather has changed in that area. Now, if the weather has changed to either foggy, overcast, or a thunderstorm, great, go and catch these Pokemon now. Unfortunately for me, that was foggy. I want a thunderstorm, so I'm going to change the date again, but I've been through this already prior to recording this, so I know the 25th is the date that I'm looking for the first thunderstorm to appear in this area. So this is what I'm doing, change the date on my Switch system, come back to the home screen, and I will go back into the game. And once I'm in the game, I can go back into the town map again and then toggle the weather on with that plus icon, and there we go, we have a thunderstorm in that area. Perfect. So we can start looking for Dreepy and Drakloak. Now, Dreepy is a Pokemon that will only spawn in the grassy areas, so it will only spawn through the icons with a exclamation mark. So they're what we're looking out for, and that's what we've got to bump into. As you can see, I'm going through this, and I will be doing this for a very long time. Drakloak is a little bit different because it will appear in the overworld, so you will be able to see when that does appear. It's still a very rare encounter rate, but it is something that you can keep an eye out for. And if you're not really too worried about which one you catch, I'd probably go with Drakloak because it's easier to spot and it's easier to get around. A lot of these Pokemon darting around trying to chase you and catch you, which makes it very difficult. So as you can see, there we go, there's the Drakloak that I did encounter, and I did catch this one here. But aside from this, we are going through a lot of encounters, and I think in total I probably was playing for around an hour and 40 minutes going through grass encounters before we do come across the Dreepy. So here we are, we finally get it, and I was so thrilled at this point. I actually thought for a moment that everything I've read is wrong. This Pokemon does not appear here, but it does. You've just got to be patient, just got to take your time and make sure that you keep at it, because the weather won't change quickly. You've got enough time to search this Pokemon out. It is just a very tedious process, but it's very worthwhile in the end. As you can see, I even had trouble catching it. I didn't really, well, I was thinking about using my Master Ball, but didn't use it in the end. Locked it in with an Ultra Ball, and we sealed the deal. So we've got both the Dreepy and the Drakloak, and all we need is the Dragapult. What you can do with the Dreepy or the Drakloak is you use a rare candy and just level it up once, it will evolve into Dragapult. So you can see that. Also nice to check the stats here of the Pokemon with the IV checker if you've got that, to see how good these Pokemon can be for a competitive scene. And if you want to know how to unlock your IV checker, I'll link on the screen right now another guide I did where I show you how to unlock that IV checker for breeding and just checking competitively viable Pokemon. As you can see on your screen right now, we've got Drakloak. as he evolves and learning all his nice moves. I will just say that this is not the only way to obtain these Pokemon, because these Pokemon do appear in Max Raid Dens. What you want to be doing is heading up to the East Lake Axwell. This is probably the easiest way to get to this area. I can cycle down over to this island in the middle of the lake, and this is the den that you want to be going for, where these Pokemon will appear along with other rare dragons. I was quite fortunate when I dropped a wishing star down this hole. This is what Pokemon popped up. It was Drakloak, but this is another method. If you don't want to go through all of the changing the weather, looking for hours for these Pokemon in the wild, this is another way to do it. Although it's not guaranteed every time you drop a wishing star that a Drakloak or a Dreepy will appear, but this is another method for you to get it and a bonus method for yourselves. So this wraps up the guide for you, my friends. I hope you've enjoyed it. Just have patience if you are looking for Dreepy. It is a very worthwhile Pokemon to get and capture. I'll be doing a breeding guide very soon, showing you how to breed for perfect Pokemon and using the Dreepy as an example of this. So hope you've enjoyed the guide. If you have, please make sure to drop a like on the video. Do subscribe to the channel for more Pokemon content, and I will see you all for the next one. So until then, my friends, take care and bye-bye.